Hello, my name's Cody, and you're watching Why Elon Musk is One of the Most Influential People of Our Time. My mentality is that of a samurai. I'd rather commit seppuku than fail. This is a quote from Elon Musk's biography, Elon Musk, Tesla, SpaceX, and the Quest for a Fantastic Future. The link will be in the description for those who are interested. One of the most influential people of our time right now is Elon Musk. He is the great inventor of our time. He'll go down with Thomas Edison, Tesla, Turing, and all the great others. But very few people truly stand the test of time. The further we go back in history, the fewer and fewer people we remember. If we look back just under 250 years ago, we can remember thousands, the founding fathers, great kings of Europe. But as we go deeper down the rabbit hole, names get lost. Who from over 2,000 years ago do we remember? Some great rulers like Julius Caesar and Leonidas. We still study many philosophers, Socrates, Aristotle, but most are forgotten. When we study history, we study the people that shape the world and what we know today. The world is going through a very strange time right now. We're changing our dependence on non-renewable energy to one that the Earth can provide for us. The man at the forefront of that is Elon Musk. Tesla, SolarCity, and SpaceX are changing the world at an alarming rate.
I mean, the fossil fuel industry is the biggest industry in the world. They have more money and more influence than any other sector. So, I mean, the more that there can be sort of a popular uprising against that, the better. But I think the scientific fact of the matter is we are unavoidably headed towards some level of harm. So the sooner we can take action, the less harm will result. So the advantage of solar and batteries is that you can avoid building electricity plants at all. So you could be a remote village and have solar panels that charge a battery pack that then supplies power to the whole village without ever having to run thousands of miles of high voltage cable. And we actually did the calculations to say, like, what would it take to transition the whole world to sustainable energy? What kind of throughput would you actually need? And you need 100 gigafactories.
Musk did something with electric car that nobody had done before. He made it cool. Before him, driving electric cars were for dorky hippies. The only reason that anyone would buy one is their moral obligation to reduce their carbon footprint. But now, they're sexy. Celebrities drive them. College kids have pictures of them up on their dorm room walls. Now, other companies are coming out of the woodwork saying that they're making electric cars too. And this competition is good for our planet. During the Cold War, we had the space race. The USSR and the United States were trying to tackle the great nothingness of our universe. Going to the moon was their number one goal.
We choose to go to the moon! We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other thing, not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Because that challenge is one that we're willing to accept, one we are unwilling to postpone, and one we intend to win.
Slowly, the will to do so is lost. And the space program slowed down, until SpaceX, which has ignited the spark for the exploration of the universe once again for everyone. SpaceX has some very ambitious goals, but so do all of Elon's companies. Their main goal is to colonize Mars, which sounds like something out of an 80s sci-fi novel, but it's goals like this that keep Elon pushing the human race forward. We as a human race need to continue and have a common goal. The reason America wanted to be the first country to go to the moon wasn't just to stick a flag in it, but it was the prestige of it. Elon's also concerned of what the future technology holds for us. He fears what AI could do to the human race. He stresses the evil that it could bring, anything from advanced AI getting into the wrong hands of people, to AI replacing millions of jobs causing mass unemployment, creating the largest inequality gap the world has ever seen. There are many people who change the world, for the good and the bad, but the ones that stand the test of time are those who change the world like nobody's done it before them. When we eventually do have 100% renewable energy, we're going to look back at the people that helped us get there. When we colonize Mars, we're going to look back and see SpaceX at the forefront. And when our grandchildren open their history textbooks, the man staring back at them is going to be Elon Musk. Those who would like to learn more about Elon Musk, the link to his biography is in the description, Elon Musk, Tesla, SpaceX, and the Quest for a Fantastic Future. Be sure to follow me on Instagram and Twitter, CP_McMullen, and stay tuned by subscribing to the channel.